In the next program, we are going to print positive and negative numbers from the given array elements separately. So like in previous programs, I'm asking user to enter n, and those n number of array elements will be accepted and stored into array with this block. It is a standard for loop where we'll be scanning all the array elements. And once that is done, we are going to check all the array elements with the condition whether each array element is less than 0. If it is less than 0, then it is a negative number and then we will print it. Similarly, we'll have another for loop in which we will print positive elements, and it will loop through all the array elements, and all the array elements will be checked for this condition that a of I is greater than 0. If the condition is true, that means array element is a positive number and we will print it. So suppose user has entered 6 as value of n, then this block will accept 6 array elements. So starting from 0 till 5, total 6 array elements will be used for storing different values. So suppose user has entered 100, 20, minus 30, 0, minus 10 and 3 as array elements. Then in the second loop, we are going to print negative elements. So iteratively, we'll be checking all these values. So a of I less than 0 is our first condition. So in the first iteration, a of 0, which is 100 less than 0, is a false condition because 100 is not a negative number. So this will not be printed. Similarly, 20 less than 0 will also not be true. And then in the next iteration, minus 30 less than 0, which is a true condition. So on the output screen, current array element, which is minus 30, will be printed. In the next iteration, condition is 0 less than 0, which is a false condition. So 0 will not be printed. And in the next iteration, minus 10 less than 0, which is true condition. So minus 10 will be printed on the screen. And in the final iteration, 3 less than 0, which is false condition. So 3 will not be printed. So while printing negative elements, minus 30 and minus 10 will be printed on the output screen. Similarly, in the next for loop, we are going to check positive elements. So our main condition to be checked is a of I greater than 0. So in the first iteration, 100 greater than 0 will be checked, which is true. In the next iteration, 20 greater than 0, which is true. And in the next iteration, minus 30 greater than 0, which is false. Similarly, 0 greater than 0, which is false. Then minus 10 greater than 0, which is also false. Finally, 3 greater than 0, which is true. So in this for loop, 100, 20 and 3 will be printed. So on the output screen, because of this loop, these values will be printed, and because of this loop, these values will be printed. Important thing to notice here is that 0 was not printed by any for loop because 0 is neither positive or negative, hence it was not printed.